Hi, Mr. Kat. My name is Hannah. I'm going to interview and examine you today.
Okay. Sounds good. Thank you.
What brought you here today, Mr. Kat?
The back pain. And the annual checkup.
Okay. And you need an annual checkup too. When was your last checkup, by the way, Mr. Kat?
About 3 years ago.
3 years ago. Do you have any date to be examined?
Maybe in April 2021.
Okay. Did you find any findings about your checkup? I mean,
they had me do an MRI, and they found a bulging disc in my lower back.
So, did you, in relation to your bulging disc, did you have any pain, or did you?
Yeah, I had pain.
From scale 1 to 10, what is your pain scale, Mr. Kim?
A 6.
That's pretty high. Yeah. Must be hard to walk around and move around having that pain, Mr. Kim.
Yeah.
Do you use any relieving measures?
Ibuprofen.
You take medication?
Yes.
Does it help you, the ibuprofen? It's an NSAID.
Not all the time.
Not all the time. So, ice pack and actually warm packs also help. Actually, the ice pack to numb your back. It's really painful. And then if you want to loosen up the stiffness, you can also do the warm packs.
Okay.
That'll be good. That'll be helpful too. So, going back, Mr. Ken, do you drink alcohol?
Yes.
You drink alcohol. Like how many times a week?
2-3 times a week.
2-3 times a week.
Preferably beer.
Preferably beer. Do you suppose to smoke?
No smoking.
You don't smoke. Okay. Do you have any history of surgeries and hospitalization?
Appendix in 2011.
So other than that, you're really healthy.
Yeah.
What about any medical problem list that you have?
Allergies.
Do you take anything for your allergies?
Claritin.
So your allergies, usually what triggers them?
The dust, when it's windy, dusty.
So seasonal, huh? Do you have any allergies, Mr. Ken? Food allergy, drug allergy?
Nothing I'm aware of.
So you have no drug allergy?
No.
What about food allergy?
No.
So you're pretty healthy. What about your immunization? I got
the flu vaccine and the COVID vaccine.
When was the last time you got the COVID vaccine?
Wasn't too long ago, 10/23/22, and the second one was in November.
Mm-hmm. So you're pretty up to date with your vaccination. Do you take any drug allergy for your allergies? Any medication for your allergies?
Just the Claritin.
Okay.
That's all.
And we don't usually combine the I know you're saying that you're taking NSAID, the ibuprofen with alcohol. We recommend not to combine the medication and alcohol. So are you, what about family history, Mr. Kat? Do you have any diabetes or high blood pressure, hypertension in the family?
No.
So both parents are still alive?
They're both still alive and they're separated, but they're both in good health.
Okay, that's good. What about your diet, Mr. Kat? Do you drink, do you have any preferences when it comes to your food?
I like pizza, frozen meals from Trader Joe's.
How many times?
Between both of them, 5 times a week?
5 times a week. And your diet is mostly high in... Could you restate that again, Mr. Ken, for your diet preferences?
I like pizza. Yeah, the frozen meals from Trader Joe's Market.
Anything else?
I drink coffee, 2 to 3 cups of coffee every day. I eat red meat twice a week, so I like steak.
So, do you exercise, Mr. Kev?
Probably 5 to 6 miles. Walk 4 times a week.
Yeah, exercise is really, it's really healthy and this is good for your heart to do walking and cardio exercise. What about with your, are you married, Mr. Kim?
Yes, for 12 years. Married to my wife, 12 years.
Are you in a monogamous relationship?
Yeah, we're
one partner.
Yeah, we're happy with it. Yeah.
Okay. What about your sleep pattern and your stress relief?
I usually sleep 6 to 8 hours a day.
6 to 8 hours a day is pretty good sleep for you.
A night, yeah. Okay.
And your occupation, Mr. Ken?
Amazon logistics.
Okay. Do you live in a house, apartment, or
a house?
Okay. And what about your religion preference? Do you have any religion?
I wasn't brought up in a religion. I was never brought up in a religion when I was younger. But my wife, I joined my wife when we go to church together in a Christian church.
You have a good family support system.
Yeah.
Okay, and then what about when it comes to safety at home? Any hobbies that you like?
Safety? I have firearms. But they're in a safe.
So do you have a swimming pool at home?
We used to have a swimming pool, but not anymore.
And do you usually pretty good at wearing seatbelt at home when you're driving, right?
I always wear my seatbelt.
Okay. So do you have any, did you notice any weight loss or fatigue that you experienced in your body?
Not that I recall.
Any complaints on your eyes?
No.
Blurred vision? Or double vision?
No.
Okay. What about issues aside from the you mentioned to me earlier, the rhinitis for the ears? I mean, sorry, for the nose. Do you have any issues for your ears or throat? Anything like that?
No.
Okay, what about some chest pain, palpitations?
No.
Do you have any issues?
Never.
Okay, what about, do you have any cough right now, shortness of breathing when you're walking or doing activities?
No.
Okay. Any problem with your abdominal issues also?
No,
nausea, vomiting or heartburn? And you're pretty regular or you do take some problems with your any issues with your abdomen?
No, never.
Okay. What about your do you have problems? Pain?
No.
Okay. So you've been drinking pretty good with fluids, right?
Yeah, drink a gallon of water a day.
And any problems with joint pains and arms, or are you able to stand with your steady gait?
Yeah, just my lower, just my lower back hurts every once in a while.
Okay. I would. Are you doing any back exercise, like stretching?
I went to a chiropractor for a while.
Oh, you did. You did that pretty hard.
And it helped. Yeah. I did physical therapy for a while.
Do you have any rashes that you would like to mention from head to toe all over your body?
No.
That we might miss?
No, no rashes.
Any headache or dizziness?
No.
So just those two, huh? The back pain and also just do an annual checkup.
Right.
Any problems with sleeping or any suicidal ideation or?
Only problems with sleeping is when my back hurts. It's hard to sleep.
Okay. Any, do you feel depressed or anxious about anything?
No.
Okay. Okay. And then you did mention that you're allergic to dust and pollen earlier. And do you have problems with easy bruising in your body or any part of your body?
No.
And then do you have problems with urination or peeing, too much thirst, excessive hunger, or cold and intolerance?
No.
Okay. So, Mr. Kent, as I'm looking at your problems and issues, so we do need to address some few issues, like the higher risk. So one of them is the risk for hyperlipidemia, due to age, ethnicity, low HDL, and high LDL, usually secondary to frequent intake of frozen food and red meat. So as you mentioned earlier that you like to eat red meat 5 times a week or 4 times a week?
No, red meat 2 to 3 times.
Yes. So we have to be careful of our intake of red meat due to high cholesterol intake. So you're more high risk for that. So we're gonna do a lipid profile. We just want to make sure that we have a baseline to prevent stroke and CKD. Okay. And another issue that I would like to address to you is the risk for hypertension. Okay, since a lot of the frozen food, Mr. Ken, is high in sodium. So we try to do a DASH diet, and it's a more high fiber diet focusing on magnesium, calcium, and potassium. So I would recommend you to do the DASH diet.
Okay.
So that is, as I mentioned before, the risk for hypertension due to high sodium and high stress level. Mm-hmm. Those goes hand in hand. And another thing that I would like to discuss to you, Mr. Kent, is your high risk for injury due to your back pain secondary to bulging disc that you've been having for quite some time. As you mentioned, your medication does not help as much. So that's why I would suggest to have a referral or follow-up plans with orthopedic and also a physical therapist for proper stretching and exercise. As personally, I have an issue with back pain also, that the physical therapist, the PT, helped me a lot with the inversion table also helped. So I would suggest that and try to monitor also other lab works that we need to do or follow up. And I need you to follow up people so in 2 weeks. So preferably we might check on your we might try to do MRI again. MRI, I've done before. MRI, CBC, lipid profile, and CMP, and I would like to check also your blood sugar. And for the ineffective pain, the risk assessment for risk assessment for pain, I would recommend ice packs and heating packs, and the TENS machine also help on your back.
Okay.
Kind of just those sleeping nerves to help waken that up and loosen it. And then the exercise is really helpful. So for those are the diagnostic plan that we have, Mr. Ken, as I mentioned, CBC for iron deficiency, MRI for further investigation of existing bulging disc, and A1C level for any blood sugar issues. And as I mentioned earlier, the lipid profile for a baseline measurement for cholesterol, HDL and LDL, okay? And the therapeutic plan, Mr. Kent, as I've mentioned before, is to implement a lifestyle such as incorporating the DASH diet, which I mentioned earlier, to prevent hypertension, limit foods that are high in sodium, saturated fats, and high in sugar. And of course, increase foods that are high in potassium, magnesium, and also increase your fruits and vegetable, high fiber diet. And you need to follow up with me in 2 weeks, as I mentioned earlier. And then I would encourage you to have exercise 3 times a week. And relaxation techniques by attending yoga classes. There's so many types of yoga, but pick which one that works for you best for a stress buster activity. And I mentioned also before, the inversion table for back exercise and proper stretching is important, especially early in the morning. The inversion table will help that. And again, cold packs, warm packs to ease stiffness and back pain. TENS machine for back pain also. Okay, Mr. Kent, I mentioned I'm going to have a referral for you for the orthopedics and physical therapist for proper exercise and techniques for further treatment. So I'll see you in 2 weeks for evaluation treatment of lung values, Mr. Kent.
Okay, thank you. Thanks for your help.
You're welcome, and I'll see you.
Thank you.